Okay, let's start. The next talk will be Blending Debian by Andreas Tille about Debian Pure Blends as a way to structure the project. If there are any questions, please raise your hand and wait for the microphone. Andreas, your turn.
Hello, everybody. Nice to see you here. It's not that crowded the room, but I hope I could entertain you a bit the next hour. Okay. I give a very short introduction to Debian Pure Blends because I'm at all DebConf I'm joining, have this talk, but no slides will be repeated, I can assure you. So Debian Pure Blends, or in short, Blends, is a subset of Debian that is configured to support a particular target user group out of the box. And the first goal is to turn Debian into the distribution of choice for a specific target user group. And the goal two, which we, in my opinion, do not regard so much, is to advertise this fact to the world. So, I mean, the world should know that there is some Debian Edu project and they should use Debian if they want to run a school, or they should know that there's a Debian science project and scientists are served well inside Debian. This is the point I want to make. So I try to explain it in several ways, and today I try it with a comparison which might be at some point weak, but comparisons are there to let you think about, and I just want to keep you busy thinking. So if you think of a herd of a flock of sheep, they are surrounded by a fence, and sheep are happy with the fence. They have grass, water, and air, that everything they need, and it keeps them safe. And they are really happy saying, meh, and I'm fine with grass, it tastes fine. And I've heard some rumor that outside the fence is some greener grass, but I just don't care. Just leave me alone. I just want to stick what I have here, and I feel good. And did you ever try to explain a bird the sense of a fence? How would you try doing this? I mean, this is what an additional degree of freedom means. And freedom means this bird has a completely different view to the world than the sheep. And he said, well, a fence might be a useful thing to drop something on it. I wonder what these animals don't fly. And by the way, the grass is more greener on the other side, but they don't care. So how can we establish the communication between sheep and bird? It's currently not very fruitful. And so I think we as a distribution should find a way to make the communication between single developers and people who are potential users but don't really know it. We should try to make them communicate a bit. And this is a really hard task because you have to cross the distribution, a dimension. Because if you are used to have a fence around it and you are happy about it and you don't miss anything, it's hard to talk to somebody who learned about freedom in another dimension. And people, or the usual users, just don't care about non-free stuff. If you ask here, is this okay if Debian keeps completely free and hardware drivers, everybody raises his hand. We just have seen it in this speech of Stefano on the first day. But if you go on the street and ask the people, the only important question is, do I have to pay for this? And it is really hard to find a way to communicate to people that the price in, measured in money is not the point, it's just the freedom. And in my opinion, we continue to fail to explain this. So we need some transmitters. Who can fulfill this transmitting role? This is, in my opinion, we have in Debian a lot of people who are working in certain work fields. I, for myself, are working in a medical institute. Others are working in schools, are working in different places where there are experts and they are respected experts amongst their colleagues. They seem to be a little bit crazy, a little bit geeky, but I hope that to some extent they have some contact to their colleagues. And my main problem was explaining my colleagues the only question, which was, what are you doing? What can you give me to make my work more expensive? And this was my reason when I thought, well, we should make it a little bit more visible what we are doing. And I tried to make it visible on some web page we designed here for this is just an example for Debian Mate. We have for other projects. We have this web page where we list all those packages which are inside Debian, which are relevant in this specific example for medical practice. So we have, here's one example, three diams. It is used to have some organize some drugs. And the people can read about this. And they cannot only read about it, they can also read in their native language. You see the translations. This is quite important, because if you are in a school or so, you cannot expect that people are reading English. So you cannot present an English page, you need to have a translated page. And this web page even has a feature. This is, an example is German. There is a German translation, but you may see it is wrong. So the user can go there and fix the translation. And there are other examples where we don't have a translation. And the user can go there and say, well, I can translate it. So by trying to involve the users in what you try to tell them, this could be one way to make them know better what we are doing. We can also show them a screenshot of this program. It's a little bit low resolution here, so you won't see it. So if you try to answer the question, what are you doing? You can say, well, if you are, in this case, a doctor, and we have several examples. We have also Debian Edu example. I can show you a lot of them. You have, in this way, you have a chance to say what you are doing. And this is important because this is the first entry point. And that's why I'm quite proud that we have these web pages to make sure that everybody who is interested, who is a member of this flock of sheep, can say, hey, outside, this can be used. This is fine for you. We have also, you can see, there's a newer upstream version and or dev text. We have a lot of information on this page. We can also present how many users are using this program in this medical software. It's not that much, but there are some 13 users for some free medical software. It's not that bad. It's kind of a niche target group, but we have a lot more for people in other fields. It's just my favorite example. So what I wanted to tell you is Debian Pure Blends give those people who are experts in their working field some tools in the hand to convince others, hey, there is some cool stuff in free software. There is some collection which is really relevant for me. And so if Debian has about 1,000 developers and everybody works in a different work field, so we could try to convince a lot of people if you would start preparing this categorization inside Debian. There is a quite easy way to do so. I do not go into the technical details. If you want, you can join me. You can find the documentation, which is quite extensive, because it's so easy. There are so less to explain. Those people who can edit a Debian control file can do it. And I've talked about it previously. It has not changed. So, in my opinion, Debian developers failed to, oh, what is really no show? No, I mean, they are just singing only these high technical songs. I mean, they talk about geeky stuff to people, And that's not good. Please try to speak the language of the users. You will not be able to convince somebody with high quality and security and whatever. The user wants a program which is usable for him, and believe it or not, they expect programs to work as it is, and they are used to software which is per default not so high quality as we are using here. I just entertained yesterday morning in the supermarket nearby, on the counter, this Windows XP box was dying, and they accept it, they use it. So the point of high security is really important, but it's not so convincing somehow. They want to have a set of packages which is covering their work field. If you could replace the counter by something which looks similar or even better, then it is fine. So try to keep a focus on the application and the use for the certain work field. Then we are quite frequently saying, well, I need to write this code, go away, I have no time for your question. It's read a book or read the fine manual, and so I think it's also wrong. I think we should spend the time to find some users, and if it's about your colleagues who are working together, sitting around the lunch table or so, this is the best place to talk about this. In my opinion, we also fail to have some established communication channels. It turned out that the DebianMate mailing list was a very nice place to join Debian developers, doctors, biologists, whatever are working with this, and we need these established communication channels. We have some very well working packaging groups which are doing a very brilliant technical job, but their work is not propagated to the outside, to the final user. We need to reach them. There are several examples I could provide, but try to accept that there are people outside who need some guiding hand, and this guiding hand can be only done by their colleagues who know their problems. Sometimes we developers also fail to build proper teams. There are people who are doing high quality packaging, and but they just care for this package, and there is most packages have some environment around which somehow belong to this, and it makes really sense to stick together with other people just to reduce runover by bus factor, to make sure that the package is properly maintained. And we made a very good experience with just talking to developers which have packages which are falling in our field, and do we want to join, do we want to use our common version control system. The advantages are various, and so we somehow managed to get all developers which are working on software which is useful in biology and medicine in the DebianMate team, and this was quite successful. And I recently had the pleasure to welcome two Debian developers who just joined us. Hey, it's a cool team, it's fun, and they are starting building packages which were which nobody else had time for, and just because the team exists, the people joined, and we are stronger now. And this is a kind of important thing. So the consequence if we are failing to communicate is that there rise, I would call it in this kind of comparison, proxy, which are called derivatives, which try either fixing the communication problem, This is, in my opinion, one important reason to raise some derivatives which are just better skilled in communication with their users. They build a nice and shiny web page. They have set up some web interface for questions. And so this is something we cannot everything do on our own. But in my opinion, this is one of the reasons why we have so much derivatives. Or they provide some more dedicated system. I even learned that, for instance, there was a derivative called BioLinux, which are more or less exactly doing what we are doing in the Debian Mid team. They derived from Debian, now they are derived from Ubuntu, three people, and they didn't use all the Debian package we built, but built them in the non-policy conformant way because they considered it better, but they had a really nice web page, which was convincing and nice, and people started using this. And these were only three people, and two people left now, and finally, after 5 or 6 years, they thought, oh, why not working together with Debian? It's so cool, and we have a dedicated system, but we could make use, much more use of this, what is prepared inside Debian. And this is what I really like, and this dedicated system can be perfectly prepared inside Debian. So, as I'm not bored to say, a blend is not a derivative. A blend is really not a derivative. And so, derivers might really consider fixing the problem as it roots. So, if they have a problem with Debian they want to solve, just talk to us. It's nice to have a lot of them. We talked about this. I'm a favorite of derivatives if they make really sense. It makes not sense to have a very specific problem and think, oh, there's a problem. I will fix this on myself. You will not be able to fix it on yourself over a long time period. All attempts I've seen somehow failed because of manpower or whatever. And there are so many adaptations you can do inside Debian, which is perfectly fine. So I would like to advertise a blend, if you really need a derivative, to make it inside Debian and prepare it Debian so far as you can do. And you should demand the duocracy principle. You really can do it inside Debian. Just join us. You don't need to be a DD, you can become one, but there are so many people who are helping you. It's called the sponsoring system. So just go on. As I said, a blend is no derivative, but we can help to preparing it. So my imagination of spreading Debian over the world is just like this. We have several work fields covered, and if you see the space is filling up more and more. If you widen those blends which we have now, and we could have even more, and so we could cover all the space of available applications, and we could make Debian even more interesting in so many fields that at any topic you want to this, and we can really make more users by spreading this word and spreading over a lot of computers. So, this is what I mean with covering more work fields. There is so much left inside Debian. I could imagine to split up the Debian science into Debian mathematics, Debian physics, Debian weather, or call it what you like it. We currently have a Debian chemistry and a Debian Med, which covers biology. Or you just imagine what you can do. And there is always a chance to categorize your software and present it in a set of packages instead of a single package. I also ask you to build strong teams around it. And if you have seen the framework here with the web pages, we have this page which is user oriented, and we also have pages for bugs. One moment. You can see here. Oops. For instance, as a developer, I would like to see those problematic packages or categories which are interesting for me, and I try to fix bugs in this category. So if I'm a medical doctor, to stick to this example, I can see all those bugs which are relevant for medical practice on one sheet. These are not so much because we have not so much packages there. If it is about packages in the field of biology, you have some more. And we have built some tool where the developers can see all these packages are relevant for biologies. And these are the bugs. And if I'm a biologist, I have interest to get this fixed. And I really want to make sure that we have some overview over relevant packages. My hope is that we, in this case, can also attract people who also want to know, well, I'm, for instance, physics. I'm a physicist. I have some knowledge. Can I do something for Debian? And so we can direct them, go to this page, try to find a bug of your choice, preferably one which is release critical, and try to fix it. This is also one way to involve people in what we are doing. So if you have another or additional ideas how we could and use this framework to make sure that people could see Debian rather than a set of packages and of a number of single packages, just talk to me. I'm interested in knowing it. And you also can try to bring back external projects to Debian. As I said in this BioLinux example, they will not come back to Debian, rather not, but they will get a close connection, perhaps bring in additional developers. Or we had recently one example where a new derivative rise that wants to support small children or adults to have the computer best prepared for their play and joy and perhaps some learning. And we just have this inside Debian. It's called Debian Junior. And these people was not aware of this. And after I pointed them onto it, oh, and what should I do? What are you expecting me to do? Well, I don't have any expectation to somebody who wants Debian look better. The person defines what is good and what he wants to have. And according to our duocracy principle, he can change Debian the way. So I said, well, take over Debian Junior, which is basically dead, and make it what you want it to be, to just fulfill your goal and put your specific view onto Debian, because Debian is flexible enough to fulfill all this. So kind of preparing your derivative inside Debian. So this is my vision for Debian Pure Blends. Currently we have discussion about time-based release. What do you think about topic-based release? We're just releasing Debian inside blends and we prepare small or single or dual DVDs which just fits a certain topic which you can offer to somebody. I'm not very sure if it's how it could be worked out, but I think it is really what users want. They want to have, they're working on a specific topic on their computer, and we could do this. It's not that hard. The preparation is there. There is some technical stuff around it which should be solved. But in my opinion, a topic-based release is basically what a blend is. And so I think that we could do in this direction very well. So I really hope that we can have some discussion about it. And the FIRMA talks turned out to be quite with a living discussion. And if you have some ideas, I would be very happy. The talk is available, will be available soon there, where you can find all my talks. And any ideas what we can do, what you want to do, or what you want us to do, or whatever.
One of the problems I see with Blend, and I think you already know that, and at least from the start, is that it's difficult for other people to understand that it is part of the Debian project, and also what is the goal. So did you consider moving the look and feel of the Blend pages to the new Debian website style? I think it would be helpful. People would understand that it will be the same project.
It's a very good idea, yes. Yeah, we can do that. there are templates in XML. Everybody can do it. But I got the idea, and if nobody raises his hand and volunteers, I try to do this. Yes, yeah, a good idea. Any further questions, comments? Who has formally heard about Blends? Did what I talked now fit your what you are thought about Blends? What you expected, or did you thought something else about it? Obviously not. Okay. So I do not want to keep you away from having lunch if you not have further questions. I would be happy to have some question or answer some question, but it's okay if we would stop here.
Just one thing, maybe just to everybody. What I realized is what really helps people is not to speak about the technical background, like this is KDE, this is GNOME, but the other way around, what you can do with it. And this is, I think, a good approach, saying this is biological. This is just about this topic, so it's near to this. Okay.
In Ubuntu, we have a concept, flavors, which is very similar to Blends. And for some flavors, we can have something like education or medical use or multimedia. But for others where the focus is the same target audience using a different technology, we find it difficult. And I would think that it would be unwise to assert that every Blend must have a target audience, because that means that you couldn't have, say, two different Blends that use different technologies to provide a desktop experience.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think we should leave the freedom of choosing your desktop. It's, we don't care. User installs it. Usually you install Blends with either with meta packages, then you have your computer installed and add the specific topic, or it might be somebody has a very strong opinion why specifically this desktop is good for the target user group. Then you pre-configure, but you can't stop users using something else. And I also got the question on Monday if Blends are only about a specific user group by a PostgreSQL guy, because he said, well, we could make a Blend about PostgreSQL and everything what you need, but running a PostgreSQL server is also some kind of target group, and if you prepare everything what the PostgreSQL user needs with one click, well, that's fine. That could be a Blend. This is okay. It's just think flexible and say, well, we want to prepare a specific topic, and this can be, it can also be language groups some internationalization. This the group of people speaking a certain language is also a group, and we can motivate these people, specifically if the language is not very well supported by other operating systems. I just learned that, from Christian, that in Bhutan there is a language spoken. I forgot the name, sorry. And this is, at least the string is not in the Microsoft operating system. They have something which is intended to work there, but people don't realize it. So there are a lot of Linux installation in Bhutan. It's also Debian derivative, but we could try to make the things they need for their derivative include into Debian, to make everything, the control, the bug tracking system, every infrastructure we have, it could handle this. This is my idea. So if there are no further questions, we have in the afternoon a complete track about blends in the round room. It will be the first talk about Debian Edu, then we have a Debian Science Roundtable, which hopefully will be quite interesting. It had a long discussion last year. And then we have two talks which are a little bit connected to blends, not actually about blends, about application installer by Enrico Zini, which I'm very keen on hearing. And the last talk will be done by Tassia about application recommender, which is something like, I'm really keen on hearing this, and Alan had done something a couple of years ago in Edinburgh, which says, and it's basically like Amazon doing, people who bought this book also bought these books, and I want to know people who installed this software also installed this software, because this could really make the design of our meta packages and blend even better. If we know what people are actually installing, then we can do it even better. So this is for the afternoon, if you are interested. So there are about 10 minutes left, I think. Any further questions? So see you in the afternoon.
Okay, thank you, Andreas, for the talk, and go for lunch.